War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes.
War never changes.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Such a cute nose.
Hon, you think my nose is too big?
You have great lips. You know that?
What do you think, hon? Beard or no beard?
Nice haircut.
I clean up pretty nice.
Yeah, that'll do.
Hey, hon.
I'll just be a minute.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degree Fahrenheit.
Thanks, Cosworth.
Of course, sir.
You see, Jimmy, our government has police too.
Wow, really?
That's right. Which is why we've developed some whiz-bang new weapons. So bullies around the world never bother us again.
It all seems so serene.
We should take Codsworth to be serviced soon, don't you think?
Oh, sounds like someone made a sticky. I shall attend to young Sean.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean. Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... it's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Why, thank you.
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. Won't take but a moment.
Sure, let's do it.
Splendid!
He's very
Splendid.
Cheerful.
Now, let's see.
Yeah, I think I'll do that. As per stream title, he will be Bruce Bastard.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Mr. Bastard, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard Codsworth. Go on. How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
Followed by... yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes.
And the shit is about to hit the fan.
We're, trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
On the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female.
Okay. Thank you.
Good luck, ma'am.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's gonna happen to all those people outside
We're
the
doing
gate?
Everything we can. Now keep moving. Step on the platform in the center.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too. Oh my God!
Hold on!
That is some scary shit.
We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we had left a minute later,
no,
we'd
no.
all be.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Hun?
This is our new home.
Please, head up the stairs.
Welcome, ma'am. Pick up a suit right over there.
Here you are. Head down the hall for me.
Good. Right over there. Just step
take a vault seat, then head down
over
the hall.
There. Take a suit.
You'll need your suits before we can take you further.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
It's down the hallway right there.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here. This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother Sir? And father down in D.C. Oh, God.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Move along.
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
The vault suit is designed to be fashionable and comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Just step in here and put your vault suit on.
Shh. It'll be okay. Daddy's right here. See?
Honey.
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
There he is. See?
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you. Why would Vault-Tec do this?
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back. I promise.
Hello? Anyone?
Why? Why'd they do this?
See what we can find in here then. More dead people, it would seem. So, as with every vault, it's just literally an experiment of some sort.
Energetic array.
Loot, loot, wonderful loot.
Giant.
Take that, Rad Roach.
Roaches? What the? Giant.
Take that, Rad Roach.
Roaches? What the hell?
Die, bitch. I'd say that person's been dead a fair while.
What happened here? Where is everyone? Is this all that's left?
Stimpak gun. Oh yeah, we know all that. Seen all that already. And it's all just a bit wrong, really.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
More guns.
Got this locked.
Okay. Let's get out of here. I knew you bastards. remove a dead hand from that. Thank you very much. It's a bit dusty. Kilobytes of RAM. Let's look a heart map to the Commodore 64.
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
Thank you very much. Don't want to miss those. More rounds. Thank you very much. Yeah, but you never know when all this shit will come in handy.
Exciting with you and Mrs. back. Where is your better half, by the by?
They came into the vault. Maybe you saw them, armed, wearing strange outfits.
Only Miss Rose's boy running around in his Halloween costume more than a week early. I swear, the nerve of that woman leaving her brat unsupervised. Not like this family, sir. You and the missus have always been such a responsible couple. Where is she, by the by?
They killed her.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little, for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car! The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. Bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you as a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
Have you seen anything dangerous?
Oh, just the usual, sir. Pesky neighborhood dogs and mosquitoes. Shall I investigate?
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir.
I do like Codsworth. Junk.
Hey, Codsworth.
That's the reason I called myself Bruce Bastard, just to hear Codsworth call me Mr. Bastard.
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
What about Concord, sir? Plenty of people there. And last I checked, they only pummeled me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station? I shall remain here and secure the home front. Very happy.
Coming, buddy.
That's it.
Find the house has got the floor safe in it then.
Hey, boy. What are you doing out here all by yourself?
You lose your owner, buddy.
Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Don't think I can pick this.